about the 10 Dahmer Brown, around the 10 places that we physically exist in, 10 places or 10 conditions, 10 worlds that we create for ourselves. Why is it called Dharma realm? Because Dharma is how we call everything. And this everything is created by our mind. That's why it's called Dharma realm. Okay, so it's all created by us. From the bottom to top, there are 10 places. The first is called hell. Who created hell? Hell is when you're very angry all the time, or you're depressed, or you have a lot of negative emotions. So this is a place that where we're very miserable and you feel like you're in the prison. Even when you're living as a person, you can be in hell because of your emotion. You will live in a beautiful place, and you will live in a mansion, but your heart is full of turmoil and depression, then you're still in hell. So hell is created by yourself. The second is called hungry ghost realm. The hungry ghost world is when we're very selfish. We're always desiring things for ourselves. You're always thinking of what do I get, you know, craving, and you're all constantly dominated by this feeling of craving for things. The third is the animal realm. So you say, why is animal not good? You know, they're so cute, okay? Animals, they can reason, they can think, they're kind of ignorant, they can think like humans. We have the ability to reason and have a lot of wisdom and think logically. The animals, they just follow their instinct. They have a lot of, you know, sexual behavior. They just follow whatever they're craving. When we are very emotional, we are in the animal realm. When we're just constantly being very ignorant and foolish and living by our instinct. The more craving you have, the more selfish you are, the less happy you will be. So these three realms are the non-virtuous realm, that the bad realms. And these three are the virtuous or good realms. Okay, so the fourth realm is called the Asura realm. Asura realm, they do good deeds, but they're always jealous of others. Okay, they do good deeds, but they want to be number one. Okay, one number one on whatever good deed they're doing. So that is still a good realm, but it's not perfect because you have a lot of jealousy of others doing better than you are. If you're always jealous of others, you live here. Okay, you're always jealous of others. And the fifth is a human realm, human world. We are physically in the human world right now. Human is a mixture of good deeds and bad deeds. Sometimes we're good, sometimes we're bad. Good thing about human is we can reflect and we can change our ways. A lot of other realms, they can do that. Okay, we are the only one that can really improve ourselves and become a Buddha. We become a true enlightened being. The human realm is actually the best realm to cultivate. And to, because we have a lot of tragedies and, you know, difficulties in our lives too, but we also have a lot of wonderful experience too. The last good realm is heaven. The heavenly beings, they are very compassionate. They always think for others, help others. You know, they're full of loving kindness and will always do things for others. So if you're always kind and loving, you live in heavenly realm, in heaven, you're in the heaven. So these are the six realms of reincarnation. When you die, next lifetime, you can go to any one of these realms. But if you cultivate Buddhism, you can go up to even higher and get out of the reincarnation. These four are the realms of sages and enlightened beings. Seven is called arhats, or sound here, arhats. They are ones that really learn the Buddhism, understand the impermanence of life, and they let go of the idea of self. They let go of their ego. They're no longer having their own desire, their own emotion, and everything about themselves. They let go of the idea of personhood and the ego and become arhat. The next one is the Pratyeka Buddha. They're like the arhat, but they don't need to listen, but this is listening to the teaching of Buddhism. They can become enlightened by themselves. Just by looking at the trees, looking at the mountains, and they realize, oh, everything is changing, everything is impermanent, everything is based on cause, condition, and there's not a selfish me that's inside of this thing. So they become completely aware, and realize the true nature of the universe. So they are called the Pratyeka Buddhas, become fully realized. These two, they only focus on their own practice. They don't try to help others to become enlightened. But Bodhisattva, not only do they want to have enlightenment for themselves, they want other people to be enlightened. They want to help others to come into full enlightenment. Okay, so they help others. The last one is the Buddha realm. This is the combination of arhats, and because they come to self-realization about themselves, they also help others. When you're in the perfect, complete balance between these two, you become the Buddha. Because you have the complete wisdom and the complete compassion. That is perfect and supreme, and then you become a Buddha. All of us have the quality of the 10 realms inside of us. But we all have the potential to live in these 10 realms. To fully understand all Buddhas of the three periods of time, to fully understand what is a Buddha. Okay, Buddha is basically a person. Okay, Buddha is not a god. Anyone can be a Buddha. So from the three periods of time, the past and the present and the future. So you want to know how do the past, present or future Buddha came about? You have to contemplate the nature of the Dharma realm. You have to understand what's the nature of these 10 places. The nature is everything is created from the mind. So what's the true nature? All these are created by your mind. You have 10 drawers. Which drawer you want to open? It's up to you. Buddha is still living in this world, do everyday activity, still go to work and still have family. But it's just they're full of compassion and wisdom and let go of the idea of the self. And they are a Buddha, full of compassion, courage, love, life force and creativity. But they're just a normal person. You have the potential to be a Buddha all the time. As long as you contemplate on the idea that you have the Buddha nature. All you have to do is contemplate on the fact that I am a Buddha. I have Buddha nature. So when I deal with everybody around me, I want to be compassionate. I want to let go of my anger. I don't want to be greedy, foolish. You know, I don't want to be in other realms because I create my own Buddhahood. One realm contains all other realms. For example, I am a human right now. But if I always think about helping others to become enlightened, then I am a human, what?
Bodhisattva.
I'm a human, but I always think about help others. But if I'm always fighting, always angry, then I am a human, what?
Asura.
Hell.
Asura.
One contains the other nine. But it's up to you to always choose to be in the higher world. There's a Frenchman, he works in a department store. One day he was fired because he had no job and he's poor. His wife took the kid and left him. So he felt like it's the end of the world. He wanted to commit suicide. He talked to his best friend. I'm gonna kill myself because I feel life is meaningless. I'm at the bottom of life, it's meaningless. I wanna kill myself. And his friend told him, I know this great psychic. Maybe you should go to the psychic first, you know. He can tell you something about your life. So he went to the psychic and the psychic told him, you know, last lifetime you were Napoleon. And you can do great things. You'll be very successful, whatever you're doing. And then he said, oh, I'm Napoleon. So he decided not to kill himself. And he started working, he said, I am Napoleon. Every day he kept telling himself, he is Napoleon. And then he started looking for another job in the department store. And now he is the owner of the largest department store in France. How does this come about? Was he really Napoleon in his last life? We don't know. But he thought he is, and then he changed his life. It's all up to you to change your life just by how you think. If you think I'm a Buddha, then I'm a Buddha. Nothing else will interfere with you of your dreams. And you can make all your dreams come true and live a joyful life. Okay, so that's the class for today. Thank you for listening. Omitofo.
Thank you.